Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and welcome back to Automobilista for some more V8 Supercars action. Today, we are back at the Darwin SuperSprint for what is my recreation of this week's round of the Virgin Australia Supercars Championship. So, race one yesterday couldn't have gone any worse. We unfortunately had an incident where I just clipped one of the GRM Holdens, and, well, that was that. Broke my right front steering. Very next corner, put it in the fence because I just could not steer the thing, but today we've managed to put it back on pole, although this time only by 12 thousandths of a second over Van Gisbergen in the Red Bull Holden, so we're going to try and get off to a good start. Yesterday we managed to grab the pole and get a 5-second lead. It was only after we pitted that we had all the dramas with contacts and whatnot, so I'm just hoping today we can go a little bit longer on this softer tyre and not have to pit so early. So today's race is the longer of the two races this weekend. It's 35 laps. It was originally going to be a little bit longer, but on the Supercars website they seem to have shortened it for some reason. So 35 laps is the distance, so we'll be pitting twice. We're going to be on the soft option tyre to start the race and then going onto the harder option tyre to do the middle stint. The softs to finish it off. So, Hidden Valley Raceway, located in Darwin, the Northern Territory in Australia. For those that don't know where Darwin is, it is the northmost city in Australia, and it is bloody hot. So, heat means tyre wear, which means we've got to be nice and gentle to these soft Dunlop tyres. Once again, in the Todd Kelly Nissan Ultima. Once again, I'm not lined up properly. There we go. So we'll just wait for the rest of the AI to form up in their usual 3-year waiting thing. It takes forever to form up in this game. I don't know what it is, but anyway, just gotta get off to a decent start. So just gonna make sure my pit stop is set up. There we go. And tire temps are dropping. It's the worst thing about starting on pole is that you're tire temps drop to the point where you just wheel spin on the start, something crazy. So just gotta focus ahead, get through turn one and get away from Van Gisbergen behind us. God, it's taking an age. Once in the next millennium. Alright, here we go. Race two at Darwin in the V8s. Minimum revs, probably let it bog down a little bit too much. Get it stopped. First lap, good second lead. Gonna head down and focus. I'm gonna go really easy on these tires, gotta try and get them to last at least 10 laps. Race today. 35 laps around here. It's very hard. Gap up even more that lap. Oh, Joseph sorted out. Locking the fronts up in some of these slower corners. Missing the apex. I've made the setup so that the car sort of preserves its rears, but at the cost of the fronts. I can deal with wearing the fronts out, it's when the rears wear out, it's when you really start to lose pace, I've found in this car anyway. Slightly too deep. Big double apex there. 2 second lead, this is good. Actually, they're starting to fight for second, so this is really good. Got a breakaway now. Seconds now, this is good. Focus ahead. It has to be one of the hardest turn ones in the whole of Australian motorsport. That straight goes on and on and on, and to get it stopped for that turn one, it's just so hard. Especially in these things that weigh about half a ton. More than a 2 ton, that's what it feels like anyway. Perfect start, just can't make any mistakes. About this left front, you keep hearing it locking up ever so slightly. Inside of that tyre is going to be quartered sooner rather than later. is beginning lap 8. So we've done well to make it this far. Three more laps, then we can pit. Lost a good second on that last lap. Alright. Rears are still handling really well, it's the fronts that I'm struggling with. Alright, so we're pitting this lap. So we are going to come out in the middle of the pack. Be a bit slower because we're on the harder tyre. Pit speed limit on this track in Automobilista seems to be 80 kilometers an hour, which is ridiculously fast. I don't know quite know why they've set it like that, but should be like 37, I believe. But anyway, DNF'd yesterday. Alright, now, we need to somehow make this tyre go... Why is it saying a lap down? I don't know quite why it's saying I'm a lap down, but a bit worrying. A glitch or something? I didn't say this yesterday. It's like it stopped scoring me or something. Really weird. Alright, we'll just ignore it and pretend we're still on the lead lap. That's really stupid. Bloody Automobilista. I give it so much credit for being so realistic compared to the other sort of V8 supercar simulators out there, and because it does this. So quick through that last sector, it's awesome. I'm hoping that the rest of the AI get a lap penalty as well, whatever that's happened to us. Battle ahead of us. Country mile away from that apex. Alright, so we need to try and get this tyre to lap 25. It's gonna be a long way, but hopefully we can do it. If we can't get it that far, we'll just have to go onto the hard tyres on our next stop. So annoying. Oh, jeez. Scary. Thank you. Oh, what the fuck? Not again! Fuck's sake, what is wrong with the AI on this game? Please don't tell me I've got fucking damage again. I don't think it's too bad. Wow, this freaking game, I tell you what. Minding my own business and freaking tagged in the left rear. Well, that's us lost the lead now. We're not going to be able to regain the lead after that. God damn it. Slightly tracking out the left rear, but we'll get it fixed on the next stop. I cannot get past the AI in this game without them freaking destroying me in some way or another. Creating some handling issues. I'm not sure if we'll be able to make the full 10 laps that I was hoping for now. Alright, so we should be on lap 20, which means 5 more laps. That the AI haven't pitted yet. Looking pretty second hand. Red Bulls without a rear wing ahead. Oh! Big wreck. Like a, I think it was a HSV and a Penske car there. Alright, so now the pit stops are starting to be made. Surprised we haven't had our first safety car of the season yet with that wreck. I have got it switched on. Interesting, they actually, that did, oh shit, that's too deep. So, they did put all the AI cars a lap down after that, which is interesting. So the same thing happened to them, which is what I was hoping would happen. So we're technically all on the same lap now, even though we went a lap down. So we are going to fall into the back of the pack, but hopefully on these new soft tyres we can rip through the field and get back to the front. I don't know how Gisbergen has such a massive lead though. Alright, so we're going to have to repair this damage on this stop, unfortunately. Few DNFs, holy crap. Alright, so where are we gonna come out? 6. Put up the lap down again, for God's sake. Alright, we'll just have to ignore that. So really we're sitting in 13th now. I'm going to try and keep you guys best updated with my position, as it seems to have glitched and said I've gone another lap down after the pit stop. Seems to be a few glitches on this track. I don't quite know why the AI aren't wearing their tyres out like we are. Usually it's fairly even. New tyres, pound away at these last few laps and hopefully get a decent finish. Somehow. How do I do it like that? last lap of the race. Slowly catching the Brad Jones Racing Holden. Got 4 laps to go. See how many we can get in 4 laps. Equaled our qualifying time. Alright, so up into 11th. Just about starting to feel the tyres wear off. Slowly going away. Alright, so I think we've got 2 or 3 laps to go this time by. Let's make it happen. Alright, last lap, come on, I want to get at least one of these guys. Sorry, maybe there is two laps to go. Huh, I'm so confused. This whole lap issue thing on this track has really confused the hell out of me. Oh, what the hell? Why is everyone braking? Oh, we're gonna get him! Oh! I think we just got the Penrite Holden. Okay, so that was the last lap. I fully apologize to the glitches on this track. I don't know what the hell is going on here. I thought that was the last lap. We've managed to get... So, ignoring everything that happened there, we actually ended up 6th. So, if we ignore the lap glitch, we're 6th overall in race 2. So, I'm pretty happy with that. I mean, yeah, we... screwed up on their tyre wear. I don't know why the AI is not wearing its tyres like we are. Usually they do, but obviously not here, which means that unfortunately we had to make 2 stops, whereas the AI only made 1. But we did manage to get back to 6th in the end, so starting off the pole, finishing 6th, doesn't look good on paper, but a top sort of 10 with a 6th place finish after all that crap that went on in the race yesterday. I'm pretty happy with that. So, thanks guys for tuning in. Stay tuned for next week as we head to Sonoma in the NASCAR iRacing Series. It's the first road course of the year in the NIS, so really looking forward to that. Hopefully we can get a win on the road course. We managed to win Watkins Glen last year, but unfortunately could not get the win at Sonoma. So looking to get some redemption this year. Alright guys, thanks once again. God, I'm so exhausted after this race. It's a real brain buster, but until next time, I'll catch you later.